Today I'm going to make a quick review in the project. This was the first idea, the concept done in the cardboard. This is the first generation that has started the testing. It still has even the stickers from the laboratory. So those was the first electrical test for the device. Second generation, this was the one that we have done the biggest improvement in the pumping the pressure and the right tidal volume and controlling the system. And this was the third generation. This one was fully operated for the patient, and this one was the device that possibly could be used in the hospital, but using the time we wanted to make the last improvement, and we have done the modification that we have added the monitoring of patient, and we are measuring the low and the high pressure value for the patient monitoring. Why? I'm going to show you quickly. This is the setup that we have used previously, and here we have the connection to the lung. Here is the tube for the patient monitoring, output from the valve, input from the valve, and here is the mechanical maximum pressure valve with value 60. And now we have the testing of the maximum pressure. Here is the constant pressure, and by squeezing the bag, the quick impulses, you can see that it's shown by the oscilloscope. By long term signal, we have the triggering the high pressure alarm. Now I'm going to change the setup and connecting the hose directly from the circuit. So now we have the same the value that is in the circuit. We have in the unit, you can see how it operates. This is the pressure that is going to be pumped, and then we have the output. If I use the peak valve, for example, we have the value 10. You can see the difference that we are pumping the pressure, and it is on the higher level. We have some oscillation from the valve. And what is important, we can have the case that this can be accidentally disconnected. So what we are doing now is I'm disconnecting the patient. So you can see that lung is not operating and the alarm is being triggered. Here you can see the low pressure alarm, and that's it. And what is the key information is that we have sent the device to the FDA beginning this week and is being processed. So I hope soon we will have good news and we will possibly get the approval, because we have done the all required work to make it happen. Thank you.